Right. So, I've had a request on TikTok to film more videos of the W3652 for YouTube. So here you go. Now, today's wash is going to be something that I don't think I'd ever really do under normal circumstances, but I've already done one in the big whirlpool earlier yesterday, and I got asked by my grandma to do another one. So, it's a quilt wash, and this is thin, but it's huge, to be quite honest. So, I'm going to go ahead and get loaded. So, the way I load quilts is off of a really old Electrolux video on how to load a comforter into the machine. So you get all of your corners first. I've just always done it like this. And I think it works very well with just loading the quilt in. So you get all your corners together, you bunch it all up like this. Get your corners in, and you shove the rest of the quilt in. Look at that. It's not necessarily a quilt, this, but it is padded, so I call it a quilt. So, door shut. Power on. And the detergent we're going to be using today is Fairy Non-Biological Liquid and Vanish Oxy Action for white, because my grandma prefers that. I wish I did have some fairy powder, because I'd rather use that than liquid, but oh well, it still works. I'm not really too sure where I put... Oh, well, here it is. There we go. Someone will do a 50 wash cap, so... oh well, that's a cap. So, detergent-wise, it's going to be that. I'm going to go ahead and see if I can... maybe, hopefully, far enough so that it gives a little lock inside of the dispenser drawer. Now, a couple of people have asked me, does this thing have halogen lighting? It does have halogen lighting for the drum, so that's what makes it unique. So, fabric softener in there. I'll put the liquid in when the machine actually starts, so I'm going to put the vanish in anyway, and no pre-wash for this. So I'll go ahead, add in the softener to the max line because, well, that's just how my grandma likes it. And that's how I'm going to treat her, because you treat your elders well as hell, because especially when they're living in the house, that's what you do, innit? So the vanish is just going to go in. I mean, there's... yeah. I'll try and do this one-handed. There we go. So, the vanish, I'm going to do two scoops, one, two, and that's that for that. So, close the vanish, put it back somewhere else, and then the liquid's just going to get introduced at some point during the cycle. So cycles wise, I'll close that. It's going to be cottons, and I do have it on the mode EU, so it will give me everything I need. I won't do short on this. I'll do cottons 60 with no short. Actually, hold on, let me go ahead and adjust that setting. So Water Plus doesn't have an extra rinse because, yeah. There we go. I know I could have just gone back, but whatever. It's just my thing, innit? So here you go. 1 hour 19. 60 degrees Celsius. 1800 RPM. And I'm going to introduce liquid in at the on the main wash fill, which you'll see anyway, probably, because... yeah. So, without further ado, 3, 2, 1, go. go. This machine doesn't have a jet system or anything, so it has no way of recirculating any water, but I do really feel like I should do that, but of course I'm not going to. Although it would be very fun. Let's just agree on that. It's taken all of that basically. It's only left a little speck of it and it'll be gone when it adds more water for the water plus feature. That's good. So far, so good. I do very much doubt that this machine will move at all or anything like that because its suspension is very stiff. So you have that. If it was mine, though, I'd definitely be doing it in some aerial powder tablets and stain remover, but, oh well, it's not mine, so I'm not going to go ahead and do that. If it was mine, my sister's or my parents, I'd do it, but, yeah, it's not of theirs, it's obviously my grandma's. Can't believe this is the second day I've had to wash a quilt, and to be quite honest, it is amazing, like, seriously, it's very fun. I could not recommend, cannot recommend it enough. Like, you just have to do a quilt wash yourself, or a duvet wash, or a comforter wash, whatever you call it. You know? It's added all the water for water plus, but I doubt that'll be enough. It will keep adding and adding and adding until it gets to a satisfactory level. I know one thing I forgot to do. I forgot to do load and detergent. Because that would have been good to adjust the machine's weight to. But, oh well, it'll probably be about a 50% load anyway. Because it is obviously a duvet. I could have done pillows or downwear, I think this machine also has. If I'm correct. But I decided not to, of course. Because, you know, cotton is always good for some things. But, yeah, I could have really done pillows or something like that, but, oh well, mistakes are made, I don't care. It's still washing in there, isn't it? It's still going to get 60, it's not like it's going to fanny around like a fucking candy and be like, oh, heater on. No, I'm not going to heat anymore, I've reached like 45 degrees, I'll be fine. I mean, that was the W1 for a while, and then obviously I actually fitted the correct temperature sensor. So now it does do 60 when you set it to 60, and 90 when you set it to 90, and everything in between. And everything before, everything in between, you know, it does any temperature you actually set it to. So that's the main thing. So yeah, today is an okay day. Let me check the time real quick. Yeah, it's 18:01, so... Yay, it's officially 6 o'clock and I only got up about half an hour ago. Because I like staying awake until really late hours. Just on calls with people, you know. So yeah, currently this is... Well, it's washing all right. Yeah. I'd say that's washing good. I'm going to just sit here and watch because it's a thing that I like to do. In a machine I almost lost. Due to unrelated reasons. And yeah. So good to actually still have this thing in my possession, because my god, the amount of shit I've been through in the past month, maybe 2 months, and a hell of a lot longer before that. I'm not getting into it, but you'll probably hear about it.
I know I'm not going to go ahead and say, oh yeah, I'm going to get into it now. No, I'm not going to, because I'm actually going to keep this video fucking clean about the entire situation. What's going on? You probably heard it already. But, yeah, I don't really care about it that much, because I'm just glad to be out of it. Yeah. So yeah, I'm just washing in my garage with a hell of a lot more fucking room, I can give you that. Just a shitload more room. And the only downside to it is I don't really have that much plumbing, so get in a hue, but it's not a bad one. I'll probably fix it, don't worry. So yeah, chilling here alone, and well, don't really have that many plans on getting with anybody again for a while, and that's fine by me, innit? So, yeah, well, fuck it. You probably understand what I'm hinting at, and yeah, you figure it out for yourselves, but don't ask questions, okay? Just try to enjoy this. You know what? I feel like the next time I actually get a really big wash day on, I'm going to film it. Because, fuck it, I've got enough time in the world right now. I have almost 3 weeks off college, and I have no intention of just sitting there and getting bored with everything, you know? So, fuck it. I will go ahead and treat myself eventually. And that will be in Abingdon. If you know, you know. And if you don't know, I'm going to tell you. I'm trying to save up about 3,600 odd quid. So I can hop down to Miele's Experience Centre in Abingdon. And then the outlet store. So I can see two machines I'm going to get. A WTR860WPM. And a WWV980WPS Cashin. Now when they're going to be able, you know, when they're going to become available on the stock lists again, I do not know, because when the hell does, if you're going to call me Lord, they'll just say, yeah, look at the current stock list. They don't tell you anything about what's going to come tomorrow, because I don't even think they themselves know, because, you know, it's more of a thing of, they get them in, they test them, and I suppose when you're calling, they are actually in the process of testing the machines for the next morning, and they don't know if they're going to pass, so there you go. It's just what it is, isn't it? But yeah, this was definitely an exceptionally rare find, and I have to admit, I'm very pleased with the way that it's turned out. I mean, it's been practically me doing everything on this from day one. Like, I fixed the drum light on it, I did a few other tweaks, and yeah, it's been mine ever since April, I think. Essentially, because I paid Jack back for his share of it, and I think I might pay my parents back for my share of it as well, so it's mine, officially. And if anyone wants it, it's not for sale, and if you want to try and get it by any other means, you're going to have to pry it from my cold dead fingers, like the rest of the machines in this bloody garage. That's all I'm going to say to you now, because I'm prideful of this, you know? Very, 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 very fucking prideful of what I've done in the past practically 4 years. Jesus, I don't even know what date it is today, but fuck it. It's probably going to be June in less than a week, and then I'm going to be celebrating 4 years of collecting. And I'm happy for once. Really, really happy. It might not sound it, but it's just because I've just woken up practically. But yeah, there you go. I'm actually happy, you know? fuck it. I sounded so bunged up. Forget it. I still do, a little bit. But I don't care. I'm happy. I've got a garage full of washers and yeah, I've taken losses on detergent and all the plumbing supplies have gone because of Jack. But yeah, couldn't care less really. I just care that I've got every single machine. You know? It's fucking beautiful. I didn't expect this, you know? Sitting here on, what is it, it's a Monday morning. Or is it a Sunday morning? Off the top of my head, I don't know. Last time I looked at the calendar was last night and I'd forgotten if it was if it was this morning early hours or last night late hours. I don't know. But fuck it, you know? I was up until 9 a.m. this morning and I have no regrets because, yeah, fuck it. It was fun. I'm probably going to end up switching over the top panels, the fascias and the kick plates on the W3602 in this bitch. Because I want a gorgeous white Miele. And I'm going to go ahead and get a filter flap for both the, well, no, just for the 3652, because the 3204 will just be yellowed and it'll look yellowed. So there you are. Let's check the, okay, this is fitted with a 2650 watt heating element. It's not any of the other Miele's in the garage that have these. You know, none of them actually have that element. So I'm probably gonna, I might fit it to another Miele if I get one at some point. I definitely have the room now, so I might get a W487 WPS. Fuck knows. The only thing I wanna do is just chill the fuck out. You know? That's what I've been doing the past few weeks. I've been chilling. Vaping. Stuffing my face with snack food. Junk. And crack. And mixing music until stupid o'clock in the morning, which is what I was doing yesterday. Oh, no, not yesterday. This morning. Really late hours. Like 9:30 in the morning kind of thing. And I have no regrets because, well, I feel happier. I feel like more of a free person now. On Friday, it's coming Friday, I'm off to go swimming with some friends. Last time that happened, or at least it was planned to happen. It did happen, but it was without me. Jack decided he didn't want to go, and yeah, he basically forbade me from going as well. So you can get a bit of a sense on what Jack is as a person. He's not a very nice person. But he did love me, I suppose, but not really. Yeah, I'm just coming out and saying that now. And I don't really care on what people's perceptions of that are. You just, yeah, it happens like that, I suppose. But what can you do? You can't do jack shit, can you? Because you're up shit creek 5 minutes in and the only way out is breaking up with that person and you don't want to do it, do you? Really? But Jack broke up with me. I agreed with him. And yeah, he then decided to just blame me for the reason why we broke up, stating that me getting annoyed all the time was the reason why, but the reality was it wasn't me getting annoyed, it was me breaking free from his controlling attitude and, well, his controlling behaviour and everything, you know. He used to say what I could and couldn't do, which mainly involved washing, which is why every single video tagged him in it. And if he made a video, he tagged me in it because I was there, because I couldn't do any washing without him being there or him filming it or some bullshit. And he's just like, oh yeah, I need to film videos to get my monetization up.
I think he'll have a hard time now because he's lost way over 12 quid a month in revenue. So I bet you his revenue is probably tanked. And nor do I really care about it. My revenue is not there yet because I'm not monetized yet, am I? But nor do I really care about that either. I don't care about making money, I just care about making people happy. Because I'm that kind of person. I already have enough money in life. I already have enough money coming in each month from the personal disability payments. And once they go, yeah, I might maybe consider making a few more videos a month and boosting the monetization. But for now, this is okay. Alright? This is completely fine. I think I've already covered enough for this. Let's go into the stats of this 3652 and everything in the garage so far, because that W3204 next year has only been filmed once and it wasn't by me, so I'll film it soon. That's modified to 1600 RPM, and I think that's about it. On the 3652 it's modified to 1800 RPM. With some of the shittiest, most bodger kind of wiring for the drum light. Oh, come on, don't blame me. It was going to be another 20 quid just to get that fucking cable. You know, it's only a 9-inch long cable, and there's three little wires in it, and it's just the usual tiny little tag connectors, you know? They're little PCB connectors, and that's all it is. It's 20 quid from Miele. I mean, Miele prices are a bit of a rip-off, but come on, man. The temperature sensors, they're just A. A-rated. They're perfect, price-wise. I mean, I've got myself a sack trolley. I mean, that's how I managed to move the whirlpool over there. With a lot of difficulty, but oh well. It was worth it, and the whirlpool's now sitting over there. So it's sitting underneath the sink somehow, and then I've got the WTK next to it, sort of at an angle. They're at an angle from each other, but I could probably film them like that if I wanted to. I don't even have any regrets about any of this. It's more of a thing of, it happened, just don't look back on it, you know? Don't beat yourself up about it, and that's how I'm taking it. I mean, anyone who's on Jack's side about this entire thing, don't be. He's lying about this entire thing. That's all I'm going to say for now. There's not much more context, but I will provide you with some later, once he is officially out of my life and I'm able to continue all the things without having to think about him or anything. But so far, he's lied about a lot of things, and he's bullshitted his way around. His new boyfriend has harassed me twice. He called me up on the phone one night while I was preparing the ASCO to go in the utility room. "Hello, Matthew, we got your phone number from the sex offenders register." What a charming chappy, not. Definitely not any kind of a charming bloke. And then I blocked his phone number, I went and told my dad about it. And my dad said, "Well, just block him on everything." I only blocked his phone number because at the time I only really believed that I had him as a phone number. I entirely forgot about Snapchat, so half an hour after that, he sends me a photo. Jack cuddling into his shoulder, him flicking me a bird. Well, what can I say? It's childish behaviour at its best, but I guess I was a bit more childish because I got my own revenge in a different way. And I guess you'll probably hear that from him. And when you do hear that little rumour about what I did with a friend of his, I'm going to tell you now it's true. And I have no regrets about it. It was entirely consensual, aside from the fact that friend of his, for some odd reason, doesn't really seem to speak to me anymore, but I don't really mind it. He was a good person, and I don't think either of us regret what we did. It was more to spite Jack. I definitely don't. just have no regrets about this entire situation, you know?
I mean, I've coated all the lights that he's got in draft.
Because he has mild skin allergies. And I... on another personal note of revenge, I did go ahead and scratch up his WML540, like the back of it, with a Stanley knife. Nor do I really care about those, because he's a terrible person. And that's my way of getting revenge on a terrible person. Like him. Forget this entire situation, you know? Fuck what I just said, don't take it to heart, I'm not a terrible person. I just decided to get revenge on someone who was. He's nicked off with most of my plumbing, and I've got no hot water over the workbench side of the garage. I mean, there's no machines there anyway, but it's still the fact that he nicked off with it. He's also nicked off with all the plumbing over the other side for two more machines, technically three. And yeah, I'm not happy about it. He's also nicked off with most of my fucking pods, because yeah, he's a thieving little bastard. And to be honest, he's probably nicked off with a light or two that I bought with my money. But I'm not fussed. I couldn't give two shits. He ain't coming back for the rest of his lights. So you can say goodbye to that Crumpack 2, the Fitzgerald, and everything else. You say bye bye to them. Because he's nicked off with more than they're worth in the rest of the stuff, the plumbing and the detergent. So yeah, the fuck right off. He was so prideful of his WML540, it was funny, because I understand it's his WML540 and he cherishes it, but there's so many of them. It's like there's more plastic in the ocean. There's more of them than there's plastic in the ocean, basically. Like, it's insane. There's millions of them that were produced back in the day, and there's still thousands knocking about. Yet, that thing was rusting to fucking pieces. I understand that it was his childhood machine, and I understand he cherished it, but my god. If I scratched it, even though it was rusting to fucking pieces, if I scratched it, he would have a right go at me. I could understand if, like, you know, that was me and a Whirlpool AWM8123, you know, I could understand it in the same situation, but a Whirlpool AWM8123 is one that I haven't even seen for sale yet, and if one does come up for sale, it's mine. I'm going to practically kill anyone if they try and nick it off me. If they do, I'll find them, and I'll kill them. Fuck it. I don't really give a fuck about this entire situation. It might seem like I do. I'm stressed about it, yes. I'm only stressed because he's lying about it. Other than that, couldn't give a shit. Don't care where he's gone. I don't care. If he ends up dead in a ditch, fair enough. There's no more lies to be told about the entire thing, because the lying side is now with it. You know, the lying side at that point would be an opponent of radio science. I would not care. You know, yes, I'd understand, and I've had, I'd have condolences, but other than that, I would not care. My respect for him is gone. And anyone who listens to him, just don't. Understand my side, or both sides of the story, before you go ahead and, you know, take his side. Or my side, if you want to look at it that way. But on an Industry Inex video, there is footage of him smacking me about. I think he did get me in a headlock in that video as well. He used to a lot, and if you're in a relationship with him now, whoever the fuck you are, and you're watching this video, he keeps his chest open, elbow him in the fucking solar plexus, because I wanted to, but never did. So yeah, if you're wondering what this random clicking sound is, I'm just messing around with a hose clamp. I'm just messing. Don't worry. So yeah, this whole entire situation could have really been avoided had he not been a control freak and, you know, physically and emotionally abused me, but oh well, shit happens, doesn't it? And I'm still here talking about it.
I could not give a flying fuck about, oh, you have to stay silent about it for a while. I don't care. I'm telling my side of the story because he's telling... I'm telling my side of the story because he's telling his and it's lies. That's the only reason. But... fuck it. Do I care? Not particularly. About this whole thing. Does it look like I really care about it? No. I'm a better person than that. I'd rather prefer to tell the honest to God truth than lie about anything. I mean, come on, a friend of me and a friend in school literally sent a Word document with 374 million E's in it. You heard that fucking right. Knight to E5, 374 million E characters, with a space in between them all. So E space, E space, E space, E space, 374 million times. It barely even loaded on his gaming setup, which could basically just support, I think it was 120 FPS graphics everywhere. It practically murdered it. The second we ended up getting a word count of 374 million. Word.exe wouldn't load the pages. That's how ridiculous we were with it. It wouldn't load the amount of page numbers we had. We sent it to our secondary school. It annihilated their servers for a whole week. I don't really think anyone knows it was us. Maybe they do. Fuck it. It was fun. We don't care, you know? It was like a zip bomb. It didn't really annihilate the school's servers. It sort of did. It made them a hell of a lot slower, if I remember correctly. But it essentially made them so sluggish it was as if they were down. And it was like that for a whole week. But fuck that. Forget about the school's server. What do they do to the computers? Oh, God. All the computers that had it opened. Blue screened, of course. When it was opened again, when someone didn't think it was that, blue screened. It was such a simplistic thing, but my God, it was funny. Fun shit, huh? Word documents. Fucking secondary school. Two kids that are autistic and have nothing else to do. Yes, we were both autistic. That's true, because I've got Asperger's, which is essentially autism. I was on a unit for autism. Autistic kids. Didn't exactly do me well for social skills, but made me a good friend, so it was alright. Outside now, just about. I don't know if it does a cool down. Sort of doubt it does, because I think it's over 75 degrees Celsius or 70 degrees or something. It might do though, I'm can't remember. I might not even have suds cooling turned on this machine. So we'll see what happens, I suppose.
To be fair, that leak is starting to annoy me a bit.
Let's have a quick fucking look.
I might know what it is, it's probably just a drainage leaking.
Probably is, let's be honest.
Or something like that. Oh well, I'll sort it, I suppose.
Be pulling machines out all day, looking for this fucking leak. Not that big of an issue though, is it? At least it's not in the house.
then I won't be fucking terrified, but it's not, so it's fine. For now. Yeah, it's definitely approaching probably 60 now. If it isn't already gone, if it hasn't already gone past 60, it's done it. Oh, that's why. There's no suds. For some bloody reason, it's actually dispensed the fabric softener. Oh dearie dear. Oh dear. Well, there's one way to fix that. Fuckload of fairy. Get in there. Screw this. Flush that down with some water as well. And then we'll watch the suds go. Because yay! We got a little bit there.
Yep. Yay, we got bubbles. That was a bit of a weird mishap.
I don't understand how that's happened either. To be quite honest,
I have no idea. But it's cured. Once I get this fucking video done, I'm gonna rip all these machines out and I'm gonna find out what the fuck's causing this dripping. Doubt it could be the 9544, it's probably something. Oh, shinny it. Oh well. It's not bad.
And this is probably going to advance on very, very soon.
Thank you. towel?
I knew that would have happened.
Jeez. Wow. Holy fucking shit.
I just hear it coming up all the vendors as well.
That's one ridiculous sex lock. It might even flick on with the error of check detergent. Which is quite possible.
I think if I did it in the W3204, it would be flashing that light, and I've never seen it flash, so I might actually make the machine do that. Oh yeah, I'll film it as well.
Working, Chief.
Yep.
Oh. Oh, Jesus. Jesus fucking Christ.
Wow.
There's nothing on the bottom of that detergent drawer, so that's gone.
That tells me something, at least. Wow. Okay, it might move over to rinses. What the hell? Fucking Christ. Wow. Okay. Maybe it's gone ahead and decided, nah, I'm just gonna keep fucking going.
Hopefully it's done that.
Or hopefully it's gonna do that. Just had tea and it was actually really nice.
It's this M&S pasta bake, or at least the rest of it. It was really nice.
Wonder. Ah, I skipped it onto rinses. Whatever though, it's still gonna soft lock. It will definitely soft lock with that.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, Sarge, that is gonna fucking suds lock. Fucking hell. I like this. I think maybe I might have overdone the fairy a little bit. But, eh, fuck it. Yeah, fuck that. It's probably going to sort of lock still. I can just tell. Heavy quilt. Maybe not. So I can't keep dealing with it. Well, something's still there. That's a bonus. Don't know why it managed to, don't know why or how it managed to dispense, but oh well. It worked, didn't it? fucking go. Second enter. I just want to say, what the fuck do this thing is doing?
You're supposed to do fucking intones, mate.
Yeah, it's gonna do
we fucking go. I don't think I really like that. It's like, this is not an experience I would recommend. For a second time. I was going for this one. Smooth as silk. Look at that.
ignorant.
New plots to be second. third into them. Forgot about that. Sorry, I was a bit distracted. Right, third into. Or final into, actually, I think. Judging by that, 20 minutes. Need about 8 minutes for a rinse, so about 12 minutes for a spin. So I'd say it's probably final into. Shut this bloody garage door, it's a cold.
It's casually waterlogging all the way. Jesus Christ. It's really bogging down on that one. Speed up. Speed up. Please don't cut out, just keep spinning. I'll try and bog it away.
Good. Jesus Christ. I don't think it's going to give up on this one. Fuck knows if it will. Keep fucking going. Fuck you. Wow. It's not giving up. It's still not giving up. It's like, nope, I'm gonna keep fucking going. What the hell? How's it? Huh? Oh, you bastard. It's siphoned out the fucking fabric softener again. I don't think I should put it up to max on this. At all, really. But, fuck it. Good lord. It's still not fucking giving up. It just does not stop. It's like the fucking Terminator. What the hell? Damn. It's been going on for like, what? 3 or 4 minutes now? There's not even a single fault code or anything.
Yeah.
Wow. I don't even think a 9.5 can top this. Or the WD-23. Jesus fucking Christ. It's still not giving the fuck up. What in the hell? How? How is it still fucking going? I'm impressed. Yeah. It's probably been going for like 5 minutes. My time perception is kind of fucked, so. Jesus. Look at this. It is still waterlogging. I don't understand how the hell it hasn't given up yet. How? This is fucking insane. I do not understand how this is still going. Damn. Wow. It just clicks over to rinses like that. There we go, final rinse, I think. Yeah, that is final rinse, even though it's taken in all the fabrics off me already. Oh well. That was insane. Why did it keep fucking going? For like the entire interim. How and why? Dude, what in the actual fuck? I'm impressed, needless to say. Fucking wow. That's water plus for it. Fucking hell. Holy shit.
undone seer, Sean. Fucking hell. That is a really good water level. Should be about to click over to rinse. No, to final spin.
serve a bit of a better purpose. Perhaps. Oh, fuck. Of course. That just had to happen. Right. Fucking wires on my ring light. Yeah, this is a bit of a botched job as this ring light, so... Pretty good bottle lock there, though. Hey, there we go. Let there be light. Doesn't really want to take that, I don't think. Or maybe, I think it does a bit of an anti-grease, I can't remember. To 1800 folks, we're gonna hop, skip, and jump all the way to it. Thank you. That's a fly. Fucking go. Ready? Fire ramp up. Three, two, one. I'm just kidding, I don't know the exact ramp up, but we'll see. It will do it. What? Nah, that's bullshit. That is bullshit. Nah, that hasn't just done 1200. Come on, seriously. Well, fuck this. Cancel. I'll just do service mode. Fuck this. I can't be asked waiting for it. Program finished. Unload the drum and switch machine off. Okay. Three presses. And we're in. Component spin. Off to 1800. Right, my apologies for that little blip, folks. We'll get there. Now. Maybe I actually might have done 1800. Fuck it, I don't know. That is 1800. Oh, maybe it did. I don't know, but that's gonna hold for about 2 minutes.
That.
There's a coat wash. So, thanks for watching. And I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.